Hello, everybody.
So, this is going to be the last part of my garage home gym. And so, I was telling you in the last video that I have a kind of a garage storage that I built. And it's kind of like a double cross. And I started thinking about it, and I was like, man, I'd love to have a pull-up bar and be able to do some pull-ups and chin-ups and stuff like that to help strengthen my back, to recover from my back injury. And so I put this in, and I am not strong enough to do a pull-up on my own. I weigh too much, and I'm not strong enough. So you'll see, basically, I bought a standard pull-up bar, installed it here in kind of an improvised way. The one thing I did to make sure everything's nice and strong is these are automotive bolts right here. I think they're called grade 8 or grade 10. Incredibly strong. Not your standard bolt that you would buy at a Home Depot usually. And you can see they have kind of a copper color maybe. It's kind of hard to see in this video. But anyway, standard pull-up bar installed on a wall, you know, so hopefully you don't have to improvise so much to get yours installed. And then the add-on I have to this is this right here. This is a nylon strap. And then you have these bands here. And these bands assist you. And so you put your foot in the stirrup here, and it stretches out the bands. And those bands at full stretch, you know, based on, you can adjust basically how far from the ground these go, and that basically adjusts how much you're stretching it out or not. So based on which color bands, and you can see what happened is over time one of my bands broke, and rather than throwing it away, I went ahead and I just bought an extra band set, and I just used one of them. So it was pretty close to the same weight of these. So these give me quite a bit of assistance at the very end, you know, at full extension of my arm. And then, of course, as they shorten up, they're not giving me any assistance at all. So when you're doing the top of the pull-up, that's all you. But when you're at the very bottom, when you're full stretch, it's helping you quite a bit. And as you come up, it's helping you less and less until it's not helping you at all. And so these are great. I'll be the first to tell you I'm not strong enough to do a pull-up. Not many people are. And this is a great way to start on pull-ups and get on the road to being able to do a pull-up on your own. And it's also a great way to you know, and most people can only, if they can do pull-ups, they can do just one or two or three. But you could actually make this into a way that you can do sets of exercises. You know, you can do five or six or seven, and eventually, hopefully, you get up to do sets of 10 of these assisted, and you can turn it into a nice workout. So, everybody have a good weekend out there, and there are many, many ways for not a lot of money to turn anything into a place where you can work out. Have a good weekend, everybody.